everyone. My name is Heather, and I'm a technical assistant at the Okanagan Regional Library. And today, we are going to use the Pigpen Cipher to write a secret code. Now, there's many applications for secret codes. Spies have used it to send messages so they don't get interrupted or read by someone who they weren't intended for. And today, we're just using it for fun. Now, parts of a secret code, there can be many different parts depending on how complex your code is, but there's really two key components. The first one being a key, and in this case, this is our Pigpen Cipher key. I'll put a link down below if you want to find it easily. This, if you think about a lock and a key, this unlocks our secret message. And the second part is an algorithm. An algorithm is a word that means a set of instructions. So I have my key and I need a set of instructions of how to use this key to write and uncover my secret message. So I'll put more information on the screen, because let's dive right into how to use this key to write out some of our letters here. I wrote the sentence, let's write a secret code, and I'm going to put secret code in our Pigpen Cipher. So, S. Now, I need to code this. So, I'm going to use my key here and I'm going to find the letter S. Now, I'm going to use a highlighter maybe just to demonstrate how I am using this key. So, what algorithm I'm using with this key. So, S, you see it's written here. And what I'm going to concentrate on are these lines that I'm highlighting. So I'm going to transcribe, rewrite my letter S into those lines, almost an upside, well, like a wide V. I was gonna say upside down triangle, but only has two sides. Now I need to find E. E is in the middle of this almost tic-tac-toe part of our key. And I'm gonna highlight what I'm going to change my letter E into. So I'm going to concentrate on those boxes that surround my letter E. Now, I need my letter C. So C has these two lines. So that's all I'm going to use to replace my letter C. R, let's see if I can do this without the highlighter now. R, where are you? There we are. So I'm going to choose this line, and that dot. Because if I didn't do that dot, my I and my R would look the same. So my two lines and my dot. And now E, I can remember we've done it once before. So it's not cheating to just refer back to something you've done. And I know I have an E down here. So why don't we fill that one out as well? Now T, where's my letter T? T uses the same line as the S and one down. So I'm going to do that symbol there. C, we had a C, I can remember what that looked like. An O, O has a bottom, left, and top line, and a dot. So bottom, left, top, and a dot in the middle. Because we didn't do the dot, well, it might be an F. And D, our last one here that we haven't done before. So top, right, and bottom. Top, right, and bottom. So, if I didn't have my other lettering here, my code would look like that. And it wouldn't mean anything to anyone unless you had the key. So if you're writing someone a secret message, try to send this to them first and then send your message. And then no one else, unless they have the key, can read your message. I'd love to see what you come up with. And just as a little teaser, I made up a joke that I wrote the answer to in a Pigpen Cipher. So I'll leave this up here. But the joke is, what kind of secret code did Vikings use? And there's the answer. If you wait till the end of the video, I'll put it in there. But thank you for joining me today, and I'd love to see what codes you come up with. Take care.